seen her burst onto the Australian music scene with her catchy hit Stylin' Up in the mid-90s. I loved that song. It was on repeat and followed up with a bunch of hits, including My Island Home. Two decades on, she is still a major force in Australian music, and she is here to chat with us. Please put your hands together for Christine O'Neill. Yeah. Things first. Wow, you look phenomenal.
Oh, thank you.
Well
thank
done. You look yeah. absolutely brilliant.
Not bad for mornings. I woke up like this.
Last year, you also spoke about how you shed an incredible amount of weight as well. You were on a health kick, and yeah, how you focused on getting yourself to a better place.
Yeah, I think it was just about getting rid of emotional baggage.
Yeah.
That is where you've got to start. It's all in here, and then once you get rid of, you know, work on all of that sort of stuff, I think everything is just a walk in the park, kind of. It's hard work.
Yeah. I'm looking at you in desperation.
Why?
Well, how do you get rid of your emotional baggage?
You talk. You talk about it. You talk lots and lots and lots.
To counsellors, to friends.
To strangers in the park.
The morning television shows. I'm so fortunate that I have the profile that I have and the opportunity to speak in a lot of forums about things that have happened in my life, to share my life experiences with people, across a lot of people. And I think that that's what's helped as well, is being able to find my voice and feel comfortable about sharing it. But the support's been amazing as well. So,
Can I ask if it's not too personal? What sort of baggage were you getting rid of? Because I just think you're perfect.
Joe's been crushing.
It's getting embarrassing.
This morning,
but anyway.
Yeah.
But what sort of stuff did you have? Was there bad stuff happening that you had to purge, or what was the sort of stuff?
No, it's... You know, we all grow up with life experiences, and for me it was just growing up with a lot of family experiences and in my community that I'm now finding a place to feel comfortable about sharing that, but sharing it because I want to help a lot of people who can see me and go, well, she's had these experiences, and talking about them and sharing them and growing and blossoming,
and we can all
move on from we are not, it is just the sum of us. It's not who, we aren't defined by our bad experiences, that kind of thing.
And of course, it's your music which also does a lot to help other people. And you got to perform at the Commonwealth Games at the Gold Coast. And how was that? How was that for you? It was great for us.
I just love being like the queen of opening ceremonies and closing ceremonies.
So you did the 2000 Olympics, didn't you?
So I did the 2000 Olympics closing ceremony right after the lawnmowers were came on and left. That was amazing. And then I got to do another version of My Island Home with a wonderful hip-hop artist from the Torres Strait Islands called Mau Power. Mm-hmm. So I did his version of My Island Home, where I got to feature in that song. So it was just wonderful. And
were you nervous? Do you get nervous when you're on the world stage that and everyone's watching you?
I still get nervous. I get nervous at small ceremonies, at small things. I get nervous. I'm nervous right now.
We do have to tackle this outrageous slur that was cast against you.
What?
There were reports that you were lip-syncing when you performed at the Commonwealth Games.
What?
Yes.
What?
Online reports on news sorts saying that the words weren't matching up and they didn't think you were really singing.
I was singing. I'm always singing. You have to sing.
Yeah.
No, I wasn't lip-syncing.
Good. I'm glad we set that straight.
Joe loves a bit of online drama.
I do love a bit. There was a report in news.com.au.
Out of the horse's mouth.
You were not lip-syncing.
No.
Can I ask you another question? Because as you know, every time I meet, I just turn to water because I love you so much. You, My Island Home, Earth Beats version from the 2000 album, was the anthem of Sydney and the Sydney Olympic Games. And I felt this was the same year, 2000, I moved to Sydney. I've got my first big job in the media, and it was all tied up in this incredible celebration of what it means to be Australian, what it means to be an Indigenous Australian. We all know that our national anthem's a bit of a dirge. Do you think we should change it to My Island Home?
I'm just going to stay out of that one.
Come on, get on board.
Look, you know what I love about My Island Home? So it's in 2016, it was inducted into the Sound and Film Archives in Canberra. So my version of it is now in is a legacy. Long after I'm gone, it's right there, right?
Wow.
That's enough for me. I think that a song lives on long after us because it's no longer about me.
The beauty of it. It's so great, and this is where
people,
I'm from.
And it is going to be for people what it is going to be for people, whether it's an anthem or whatever it is. It has a very special significance in a lot of people's lives. People have come up to me and said it was at my mum's funeral, yes. Or it was we played it at our wedding. I've sung this song at weddings. I've sung it at funerals. I've sung it everywhere, and it has a special place. Whether it's an anthem or not, it has a very special spot in people's lives, and that's enough for me.
Mm.
But if it was to be made, then would you object?
No, of course not. I'm sure Neil Murray wouldn't either.
Imagine the royalties.
Yes.
Now, you have also announced, which is super exciting, two very special Christmas shows. Right. At the Lead Belly in Sydney's Newtown.
Aren't
really too many places these days, especially in Sydney, to enjoy live music.
That is exactly right.
It's a bit depressing.
It is depressing, and this time of year. And it's even changed its name. It's now Lead Belly, but it is one of few places in Sydney that you can...
What was it? Excuse my ignorance.
Vanguard.
Ah.
It was the Vanguard in Newtown, but now it's Lead Belly. So 29th of November and the 1st of December that you can come and see the shows.
Wow.
So exciting. So I'm going to be doing a mixture of Christmas songs, a mixture of my Aretha covers, Aretha.
Of course.
And a mixture of my songs from the albums that I've recorded over the years.
And
so, yeah.
There's a bit of a push on at the moment to get Sydney, saying Sydney's not a 24-hour city anymore, to get Sydney's nightlife pumping again. Is that something you think the city needs to do to bring artists like you back to the inner city, back to sort of the streets where the people are, back to these venues, these intimate venues?
We need more live venues, and that means that if Sydney can become a 24-hour city like the rest of the world is, then it'll open up more opportunities for us to gig 5-7 days a week, you know, even. We need it. We need venues. And we don't have them in Sydney.
Well, you can catch Christine on the 29th of November and the 1st of December at Lead Belly in Newtown. Head to moshtix.com.au. Also, hit us up on Facebook. Let us know if you think that My Island Home should be our new national anthem. We should put it to a poll on Facebook.
Yes.
We'll reveal it at the end of the show. Christine Anu, you are a doll. Thank you so much.
Thanks for having me.
Thank you.
Thank you.